Okay, let's see. I have a small agency and I'm lost how to organize the full process of the client since prospecting until getting things done. I provide two service, social media and pay-per-click management. Not a problem. Okay, small agency, it doesn't even matter how small or big the agency is. There is two ways of how we set up agency clients. There was a live video, Jardim, where I was talking with Amara and Gray. They both have different approaches to how they are actually running agencies. So Amara has the approach of her structure is each client is a space, meaning she has clients on space levels. She then has the services as folders and stuff underneath. Now, I am more of the approach as Gray does, in the sense that we have one space for all of the clients. We then have a client folder, so each client gets their own folder. So let's make this completely visual. Let's just build a client in here. So we have a new folder. This is client CU unplugged, if I can spell. Cool, we have a folder, client unplugged, awesome. That one is there. That client also hired us for some PPC work, cool. And you said you are also doing organic social media. Cool. That means we are adding another list with social media. Cool. Then what we are doing is on this, on the client's space level, we have the PPC right here. So in your process of onboarding your client, what you do is you choose the location is, you go into the client unplugged and you choose PPC. So every time you bring on a new client, you keep the same structure. You build your client, your template client folder. You just duplicate that over and over and over and over again. And then the next step is going into your PPC and choosing that PPC list. That's how you then get a custom view. And again, in that client space level, that's how you get the PPC list, so your PPC team can see all they need to see without being bothered by the whole organic social media stuff. Cool. Gotta save the stuff. Autosave view. Done. Now, how we handle this in an agency setting, we don't have that kind of diving that deep into it. We simply add a custom drop-down field that now helps us of, okay, this one is an idea stage, this one is in the work stage, and that one is published. That's how we handle it there, rather than separating them out in lists. Cool, let me know if that makes sense. We have that correct. Brand onboarding. Brand is a good point. Asset management is still happening in Google Drive. I like the structure there. Just have a folder for the client, have all of their assets in there. But I want to be able to easily reach them, reach those assets. Meaning what we often do is we have a brand assets list in ClickUp and we say, here's the logo, here's the fav icon, here is this, that, and have those as tasks, those specific assets. And then have a custom field where you plug in the share link to the Google Drive assets so you easily can just link over there. Cool. In your case, you have onboarding would always be the first one to me. And the moment this client is onboarded, just drop it. You just archive that list, done. I'm thinking you are talking about brand assets when you say brand, meaning their logo, their colors, all of that stuff. Yes, totally. PPC, social media, blog, and email marketing. Yep. I would exactly do it that way, totally. But yeah, I have clients, said agency, they have, I need to say a lie, I think they have 10 lists underneath their clients simply because they do that much.